season of jubilee. It's a season of favor. It's a season of shalom. Come on, put your hands together one more time. We are a chosen generation. We are a chosen generation. Call forth to show forth His excellence. Now listen to me. Listen to me, people of God. We are a chosen generation. I said we are a chosen generation. It is not a mistake that you are born at this hour. You are born at this hour, at this time, so that you can show forth His excellency, so that you can show forth His majesty, so that you can show forth His power. Somebody give God a praise. So we are a chosen generation. I want to tell your neighbor, it's my season of favor. It's my season of elevation. It's my season of blessing. And I am a chosen generation. I'm a chosen generation. So before I forget, on the 11th of December, that is on Wednesday. On Wednesday from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., all Christians, we are gathering together at Uhuru Park for the whole day so that we can have a time of raising the Jubilee sound. We are going to run around the park. We're going to celebrate. We're going to rejoice. We're going to clap. We're going to take our position and thank God for 50 years of his goodness, 50 years of his mercy, 50 years of his power. And then we're going to prophesy into the next 50 years and declare the days of Kenya living in poverty, being an example of defeat. Those days are coming to an end, and a new dawn, a new beginning is about to dawn in our nation. If you agree with me, shout a good amen. Once again, Pastor Mobili, thank you so much for coming, and thank you for blowing that shofar. Every time the sound of a shofar is raised up, it is an indication that a new dawn and a new beginning has begun. And I want to announce that in the name that is above every name, there is a new day that has dawned over Kenya. There is a new season that has dawned over Kenya. If you agree with me, shout amen. Get your Bibles out. Let's go to the book of... Today I'm talking about the blessing of Jubilee. That is what I want to talk about. I want to talk about the blessing of Jubilee. Find a way to the book of Luke, chapter number 4. Those of you watching us by television, we want to say thank you so much for tuning in to KTN. Thank you so much for tuning in to us. We thank God for the opportunity we have to minister the word of God through KTN. We thank God for the board of directors led by Sam Chalet at Standard Group. We thank you so much for just allowing us to minister the word of God through KTN. Thank you so much to the MD of KTN, Mr. Joe Monene, my friend, and all the members of staff at KTN. We thank God for you. We love you. We are praying for you, and we know that you have a great responsibility in this season of Jubilee to ensure that what is right and proper is being broadcast. And I want to say a very big thank you for bringing the Bible story every Monday, Bible story. That is amazing. Come on, let's appreciate KTN just for doing that. Just bringing the story of the Bible. That is amazing. Amen. So thank you so much, and God bless you so much. I know we have in the service some staff from KTN. If you can wave your hand so that we can see you, it will be a blessing. Oh, they're all over there. Oh, they're here. The staff from KTN, God bless you so much. Amen. We are looking forward to having you, and thank you so much for having taken time to come and worship together with us in Jesus' name. Now look at your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, it's a season of Jubilee. Tell your neighbor, it's a season of Jubilee. Amen. I'm in the book of Luke, chapter number 4. Luke, chapter number 4. I'm going to read it from the Amplified version of the Bible. The Amplified Bible says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me, the Anointed One, the Messiah, to preach the good news, the gospel, to the poor. He has sent me to announce release of the captives and the recovery of sight to the blind, to send forth as delivered those who are oppressed, who are downtrodden, bruised, crushed, broken down by calamity, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord, the day when salvation and the free favors of God profoundly abound or profusely abound. This was Jesus who spoke these words. And I want to talk today on the blessing of Jubilee. Our dear loving Father, in the name that is above every name, I want to ask you to anoint me to speak your word with power and revelation. Let somebody walk out of this place having received a word that will position them in this nation for great elevations and blessings. Thank you, Father, for 50 years of your goodness. As a nation, we are gathering this week to just thank you for superintending over the affairs of this nation. Thank you for indeed Kenya has been a blessed country. And therefore today, as we talk about the blessing of Jubilee, I ask you to anoint me in Jesus' name. Somebody said amen. You may be seated in the presence of the living God. As we come to the climax of celebrating 50 years as a nation, and as we come to celebrate, as we're celebrating this season of Jubilee as a nation, today I want to talk to us as Kenyans, because I believe one of the responsibilities that I have as a leader, Christian leader in this nation, is to be able to prophetically declare and show us in the prophetic calendar where we are in God. It's important for us to understand what God is saying to us as a nation. Because, ladies and gentlemen, it's not just about you as an individual. Christianity is not just about you as an individual, but it has everything to do with you and the environment and the people that are around us. We are a Christian nation. We are a Christian nation. Can I get an amen from somebody? It doesn't matter. We are messed up, but we still love God. We have issues, but we are getting there somehow. Somebody say amen. And this year, ladies and gentlemen, is a very significant year because as a nation, we've been celebrating the year of Jubilee. This has been a very significant year because, number one, we've had a very peaceful election where in the month of March, we elected our leaders. And on the 9th of April, I believe was the most significant year of this, the day of this year, because we saw our two leaders, the president and his deputy, together with their wives, kneel before the Almighty God as they were being sworn into office. I truly believe that was the most significant thing that ever happened in this nation. And therefore, it's important for us to understand that there's something that God is doing, because as a people that God put in this land, he put us here on a divine mission and on a divine purpose. And it's imperative for us as a people, first of all, to have an understanding of what it is that God wants to do in our nation. And a nation anyway is not the land. The nation is a people. We are Kenya. Somebody say amen. We are the Kenya that we're talking about. And therefore, it's important for us to understand. And that's why today I'm talking to us this way, because I believe that truly we need to understand what it is that we need to be doing as a nation in this hour. Now, significantly, certain things have happened in this nation. Like I say, we had a very peaceful election. And then we elected a president whose name, President Uhuru Kenyatta, his very name means liberty. And I know we have all our political affiliations and inclination, that's okay. But you must also understand that God has a master plan in this nation called Kenya. In fact, when you study in the Hebrew, in the rabbinic Hebrew, and you study the word Kenya, it can actually be divided to Ken, which means nest, and Yah, which where we get the word Yahweh, is the word God. So Kenya can actually mean God's nest. And that is very significant. And I believe that personally, that something wonderful is happening in our nation. And as we stand on the precipice of a new beginning, it becomes important for us to be able to understand what it is that God is saying. And like the man of God has spoken here so ably, he said that we have started to realize in our nation that suddenly we have oil. We have started to realize, even in Turukana, in a place called Lokitipi. And when you check the word Lokitipi, actually in Turukana, it means there is water underground. We have found over 250 billion liters of water that can be able to sustain the nation for 70 years. And they're telling us that those aquifers are being replenished at a rate of 4 billion liters of water every year. So incredibly, where there was hunger and where there was thirst underneath, God had already positioned an ocean under the very feet of the people who are dying of thirst. That is very significant. We are starting to discover things like oil in the Gambia 1, Gambia 2. Like the man of God has said, we are actually in a place now where we're even putting together a railway line for the first time after 100 years so that we can be able to transport things in and out of our nation. We are seeing the interest of the LAPSET program coming around. And suddenly as a nation, there's an excitement, there's a buzz, there's a sense of understanding that we are on the verge of something wonderful. Now, I don't know about you, but I am the kind of a person who can sense that I was born at the right time and I was born at the right nation, and something wonderful is about to happen in this place. Can I get an amen? And therefore, it's important for us to understand what it is that God is saying. And God is a God of time and season. Write that down. God is a God of times and seasons. God is a God of times and seasons. God is a God of times and seasons. That's why even Jesus could not be born at the time of David. Jesus could not be born at the time of Moses. Jesus could not be born at the time of Joshua. He could not be born at the time of of Samuel. The Bible says in the book of Galatians chapter 4 and verse 5, the Bible says, but when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. The Bible says, when the fullness of time came, Jesus was born of a woman. So there's a fullness of time that had to come to pass so that Jesus can be born. And I want to announce to you, child of God, that when I listen to the Spirit of God and what God is saying about this nation, I truly believe we are in a season of a new beginning. I said we're in a season of a new beginning. If you agree with me, say amen. And you're going to have to help me, people of God. I say we're in a season of a new beginning. And when you look at the word of God, the Bible says in the book of Zephaniah chapter 3 and verse 10, the Bible says, from beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, my suppliants, even the daughters of my despised, shall bring me an offering. And when he talks about beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, what is he talking about? He's talking about people who beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, and I believe is this nation, shall gather together to bring an offering of thanksgiving and praise unto God. Now, what are some prophetic things about our nation? I want you to write this down. What are some prophetic things that God has spoken about this nation? The first thing you have to understand about Kenya, number one, is that Kenya is a springboard of revival. Kenya is a springboard of revival to the continents of Africa and beyond. And so when you see Kenya, you have to understand that we are not just a normal nation. We are a nation that, number one, is a springboard of revival. Number two, Kenya is also a city of refuge. Kenya is also a city of refuge. And we have seen many people that have problems in their own countries, countries like Uganda, Ugandans who have come here in the 70s and in the 80s. Ethiopians were here also in the 80s. The Congolese, the Rwandese, the Burundians, the South Sudanese and the Somalis who have come to our nation, is because our nation has become a city of refuge. And over the years, we have entertained and we have given refuge to people who are in need. And many times, the same people who came to Kenya, when they went back to their nations, they went back with the gospel. They went back having received Jesus Christ, and revivals began to break. Began to break in the nations where they went to. I cannot forget, like the Ethiopians, there was an Ethiopian church right here in Kenya, and when they went back to Ethiopia, they started a church in Addis Ababa, and in a little while the church grew from zero to over 5,000 having come from this nation. And ladies and gentlemen, let me just say something. We know right now that there's a lot of talk about repatriating refugees and taking them back home, but I pray that we shall not force them to go back, because ladies and gentlemen, we have to understand there's a blessing that comes as a result of taking care of the stranger. The Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 14 verse 29, the Bible says, and the Levite, because he has no part in on inheritance with thee, and the stranger, listen to that, and the stranger and the fatherless and the widow which are within your gates shall come and eat and be satisfied. And then the Bible says that the Lord may bless thee in all the work of your hand which you do. Ladies and gentlemen, there is a blessing when you take care of the stranger. There is a blessing when you take care of the fatherless. There is a blessing when you take care of the Levite. And when you take care of the widow, the third thing that Kenya is that Kenya, number three, is a threshing floor for prayer and intercession. Number three is that Kenya is a threshing floor, is a place of prayer and intercession. And in Kenya, we have seen caves and we have seen prayer mountains, and we have seen people going to seek after God and to pray in the secret places. And we have places like this house where every Friday night we have a whole night of prayer. Why? Because I believe that God has called us as a nation to stand in the gap for the region. We are not just supposed to be praying for our own needs, but I believe that we are in a time now where we should lift up not only our nation, but the region around us. We are supposed to pray for the peace in Somalia. We are supposed to pray for the peace in Djibouti. We are supposed to pray for breakthroughs in nations that have not allowed the preaching of the gospel. And I truly believe more than ever before that our nation has been called as a threshing floor of prayer and intercession. Now, in this year of Jubilee, what do we need to do? I believe there are five things that are important for us to do in this year of Jubilee. If you're going to access into the blessing of God, number one, we must in this year of Jubilee have a time of rejoicing. We must have a time of rejoicing. In this year of Jubilee, we must rejoice. We must celebrate the goodness of God. I know there are so many things that are wrong, and I know there are so many things that need to be fixed. But before we even fix them, why don't we stop and just thank God that we are around after 50 years. There are not many nations in Africa that have gone for 50 years without wars and chaos. You look around us, you will see nation after nation that rose up against one another. And I know we have had our share, but I tell you, we haven't even come close to what has happened in other nations. And I believe that more than ever before, it's a time for us to rejoice and celebrate and thank God for his faithfulness. Just thank God that he's watched over us. Just thank God that he's cared for us. Just thank God that we have a nation that is peaceful. And even though we may have our problems and we have our issues, I believe we need to thank God for the little that he has given us. The peace and tranquility. The fact that you can take your child to school. The fact that you can go and eat your piece of ugali in peace. And I'm not saying we are perfect. We have our own issues. But before we even deal with the issues that we have, can we just thank God that we are here? Can we just thank God that we are alive? Can we just thank God that we have a freedom of worship? Can we thank God that we can gather in a church like this and be on television and preach to the nation? Can we just thank God? Lift your hands above your head and just give God a praise right there, because I believe it's the time of rejoicing. Come on, rejoice in Jesus' name. The second thing that we must do in this year of Jubilee is that we must also reflect. In this season of Jubilee as a nation, we need to have a time of reflection. We need to sit down and reflect on some of the mistakes and the errors and failures we have had as a nation. Yes, we have messed up. We have killed. We have bribed. We have stolen. We have corrupted. And we need to reflect on these failures so that we don't repeat them moving forward. We need to sit down and reflect on some of the things that we need to deal with. We've been tribalistic. We've been materialistic. We've been greedy. We've risen one against another. And it's important for us as a nation to sit back and reflect and think through some of these things so that we don't repeat them moving forward. The third thing that we need to do as a nation is we need to have a time of reconciliation. We need to reconcile and to come together. We have allowed ourselves to be divided by negative ethnicity. We've become tribalistic and materialistic. But in this season of Jubilee, if you're going to have a new beginning, we must be able to reconcile and stretch a hand of mercy and love and forgiveness for one another. And you know, this week we had the passing of the great icon called Mandela. And one of the things that Nelson Mandela taught each and every one of us is the power of forgiveness. That we need to forgive even our persecutors. After coming out of prison, after being there for 27 years, he was able to embrace his persecutors and love them and tell them, we have to build this great nation of South Africa together. And I believe as a nation, we need to stretch our hands one to another. I don't have to speak your language. I don't have to talk the way you talk. You don't have to like my style. You don't have to like the way I preach. But at least you can love me as your brother, and we can be able to build a good nation together, because without you, I cannot be strong. I need you and you need me. We need each other. Touch your neighbor, tell me, I need you and you need me. Amen. Number four, the fourth thing that needs to happen in this Jubilee is we need to have a time of returning. We need to have a time of returning. It's a time for us to return back to God. It's a time for us to return back to prayer. It's a time for us to return back to the social values that made us cohesive as a nation. It's a time for us to turn back to honest living, hard work. It's time for us to turn back and to return back to the place of prayer, to return back to the deep love for God. Kenya has boasted itself to be a Christian nation, but I want to say more than ever before, if there's something that needs to happen, we need to turn back to God. We need to go back to the place of prayer. We need to find where the axe had fell, and we need to make a commitment to turn our hearts back to God. We need to see churches that are filled with the glory of God. We need to see families that are coming together to the house of God. Many people today have abandoned going to church for one reason or the other, and we have excuses as to why we don't want to go to church. But let me tell you this, it doesn't matter whether the preacher is perfect or whatever is happening in the church is perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, God doesn't use perfect people. He uses imperfect vessels. And please, you just have to love me the way I am, and we can come together and worship God together, even if you don't like the way I do some certain things. Somebody say return. Number five, it's also a time of restoration. It's also a time of restoration. And as a nation, I'm trusting God that in this season of Jubilee, whatever was taken illegally, whatever was taken under duress, shall be returned back to its its legitimate ownership. Because the Bible clearly says in the book of Joel, chapter 2 and verse 25, the Bible says, and now we restore to you the ears that the locust has eaten, the canker worm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, that great army which has sent among you. And I truly believe that it's a time of restoration where we need to start to see the restoration happening in those who have lost and things were taken from them in a way that was not right. Now, I want to talk to us today quickly for the next 20 minutes on the blessing of Jubilee. Somebody said the blessing of Jubilee. Amen. I want to talk to us on the blessing of Jubilee. I want you to find a way to the book of Leviticus 25, and I'm going to connect this with where I read in the book of Luke, because it's very important, very significant for us to understand on the blessing of Jubilee, and then I'm going to tie together with Jesus being the blessing of Jubilee. Now, I wanted to go to the book of Leviticus 25 because there are seven blessings that come as a result of Jubilee. Seven blessings that come as a result of Jubilee. And I'm going to do this quickly and then tie them together because we need also to understand, and I know there's some people who are asking, but Bishop, this Jubilee thing was supposed to be celebrated by Israel and the covenant people of God. Where do we come in? And I'm going to tie in that in a little while if you can stay with me. Now, quickly, I'm going to give you the seven blessings of Jubilee. Somebody say seven. Number one, the first blessing of Jubilee was a blessing of liberty. The first blessing of Jubilee was a blessing of liberty. The first blessing of Jubilee was a blessing of liberty. It is found in the book of Leviticus 25 and verse 10. Leviticus 25 and verse 10. What does the Bible say? The Bible says, and you shall hallow the 50th year and proclaim liberty throughout the land, all the land and all the inhabitants thereof. And it shall be a Jubilee unto you, and you shall return every man unto his possession, and you shall return every man unto his family. Liberty, liberty from bondage, liberty from cruelty. Ladies and gentlemen, let me just say this. Bondage is not of God. Bondage is not of God. And in the year of Jubilee, the Bible says that the children of Israel were told, it shall be an year of liberty. Bondage is not of God. And in the year of Jubilee, you must expect and believe God for Jubilee, for release of every bondage. Bondage from sin, bondage from pornography, bondage from poverty, bondage from immorality, bondage from debt. Because the Bible says that the borrower is a slave of the lender. And ladies and gentlemen, it is not the will of God for you to be in bondage in any area. You are supposed to be free. You're supposed to walk in liberty. No wonder the Bible says that he who the Son sets free is free indeed. And one of the things you must understand is that in your life, you must refuse anything that puts you in bondage. You must refuse anything that holds you down and does not allow you to rise. And ladies and gentlemen, poverty is a bondage. Debt is a bondage. Debt is a bondage. Immorality is a bondage. And these are things that in the year of Jubilee, or in this time of Jubilee, understanding who, and I'm coming to tell you who Jubilee is. In this time of Jubilee, you must believe God for you to be free. Somebody say freedom. You're supposed to be free. Free from every kind of bondage. Number two, the second blessing of Jubilee was the blessing of possessions. Was a blessing of possessions. In Leviticus 25, the Bible says, in the year of Jubilee, you shall return every man unto his possessions. You shall return every man unto his possession. Leviticus 25 and verse 13. In the season of Jubilee, ladies and gentlemen, God wants to release your possessions so that you can be able to enjoy all the promises of the Word of God. When I talk about possessions, I'm not just talking about material things. I'm talking about possession of health. I'm talking about possession of joy. I'm talking about spiritual possessions. Healing of your mind. Healing of your marriage. Somebody say possessions. You see, the devil, the Bible says in the book of John 10:10, the Bible says that the thief cometh, but to steal, kill, and destroy. But the Bible says, but I have come, that you might have life and have it more abundantly. And that word life there, it is what the word Zoe, which means a life principle that breaks you from every bondage and allows you to enter into the fullness of what God has for you. Somebody say amen. So when we talk about possession, we're not just talking about material stuff only. And we had the word only there. We're also talking about spiritual stuff. We're talking about joy. We're talking about fullness. And like the man of God said, we're talking about shalom. And shalom is a compound word. Somebody say amen. The third thing that in the year of Jubilee you must expect is restoration to your family. Restoration for your family. Restoration for your family. Leviticus chapter 25 and verse 10. The Bible says, and you shall hallow the 50th year. You shall hallow the 50th year and proclaim liberty throughout unto all the land and to all the inhabitants thereof. It shall be a jubilee unto you, and you shall return every man unto his possession, and you shall return every man unto his family. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the things that must happen in this year of jubilee is that people must have a restoration where their families are concerned. There are too many families that have fallen apart. There's so much animosity within family. And ladies and gentlemen, without a strong family, we can't have a strong society. Because the family is a microcosm of a good society. When the family is solid, the nation can be solid. Because good people come from good families. When you are at peace in your home, you can be at peace in the marketplace. When there is no contention in your house, wherever you go, you'll be at peace. And as a nation, I'm trusting God that in this season, we shall see solid marriages, children that love God, people that come to the house of God together. And that's why, like I said when I started, we must return to the pattern of going to church with our children. We must escort. We don't just send our children, tell them go to church, but we must take our children to church. And when the doors of the church are open, we must be there. And let me just say to those who are watching me by television, being on television is not an excuse for you not to go to church. This is not church. This is supposed to be just some takeaway when you cannot go to church. But you must go to church, because it's in church where you're fed, where you relate to other people, and where you connect, and you are blessed. Somebody say amen. Number four, the fourth blessing of Jubilee is the increase from the field. Increase from the field. In the book of Leviticus 25 and verse 12, the Bible says, for it is the Jubilee, it shall be holy unto you. And the Bible says, and you shall eat the increase thereof out of the field, out of the land. No wonder we are seeing water breaking loose in places where we never imagined. No wonder we are seeing in our nation, in the last few years, we've seen rainfall like measured in ways we cannot be able to understand. We are seeing a growth, and we are seeing our land beginning to produce agriculturally in ways that are just amazing. And I can tell you this, it is just that we haven't positioned ourselves to really maximize on what God has given us. We have such a beautiful land that if we were to do farming, we would not only be able to feed ourselves, but we can feed the whole of Africa. We can feed Europe because we have so much land. Do you remember the other day, the Chinese coming to us and asking us if we can give them the Tana Delta so they can grow crops, so they can take back and eat. And we are getting upset about it. But the truth of the matter is that God has given us such a beautiful nation, such a beautiful land. And in this year of Jubilee, I'm praying that we shall see an increase in our field. Somebody say amen. Now, what is the increase of our field? What does it mean? It means, write this down, prosperity and abundance. Prosperity and abundance. And in this time of Jubilee, in this season of Jubilee, I'm trusting God that you shall see an abundance taking place in your life. Can I get an amen? Somebody say abundance. Somebody shout abundance. God is not a God of just enough. Amen. Let me say that again, and I'm going to say it on air so that somebody can hear me. God is not a God of just enough. God is a God of more than enough. That's why he says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 8, the Bible says this, that God is able to make all grace abound towards you, so that you, having sufficiency in all things, might abound unto all good works. So ladies and gentlemen, God is a God of abundance. Number 5 is a freedom from oppression. The Bible says in the book of Leviticus 25 and 14, the Bible says, there shall be freedom from oppression. This is what it says. For thou shalt sell aught unto thy neighbor, or buy aught out of thy neighbor's hand. You shall not oppress one another. Leviticus 25, 14. You shall sell aught, nothing to your neighbor, buy nothing from your neighbor. You shall not oppress one another. When God pours the supernatural blessing of Jubilee, every form of oppression shall be broken in the name of Jesus. Can somebody say amen? We shall not need to oppress one another. We need to wait for people at the corner so that you can handle them. We shall not need to steal from one another. But I believe that in this season of Jubilee, we are going to enter into a place where we shall have more than enough, so that I can be a blessing not only to you, but I can be a blessing to a whole generation. Can I get an amen from somebody? The sixth blessing of Jubilee is a blessing of safety. Is a blessing of safety. And I'm talking prophetically to our nation. Understand this. I'm not talking about where we are. I'm talking about where we are going. Can I get an amen from somebody? And that's my assignment as a prophet. A man of God must speak about where God is taking them. We must speak about where we are going. We just talk about, we don't talk about where we are. We talk about where God is taking us. Somebody say amen. It's a blessing of safety. Safety. Leviticus 25 and verse 18. The Bible says, wherefore you shall do my statutes and keep my commandments to do them, and you shall dwell in the land safely. In this season of Jubilee, God shall cause his people to dwell in safety. There shall be divine protection in the land. I wish I could get an amen from somebody. There shall be divine protection in the land. As a mother hen watches over his chicks, over her chicks, so shall Jehovah watch over you. That's what the Bible says in the book of Psalms 91 and verse 3. The Bible says, surely he shall deliver you. He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. And then verse 4 says, he shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wing thou shalt trust. He shall be your truth and your buckler. And then verse 5 says, you shall not be afraid by the terror by night, or by the arrow that flies in noonday. And then verse 6 says, not in pestilence that walks in darkness, or the destruction that wastes in noonday. Then verse 7 of Psalms 91 says, 1,000 shall fall by your right hand, and 10,000 by your side, and 10,000 by your right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. I want to declare that in this season of Jubilee, we are going to see a better security structure coming up in our nation. Can I get an amen? We shall not see murders and killing and crime, but we shall see it coming down. And I know when you look at it in the natural, you can't understand how it's going to be. That's where the church becomes powerful, because we can stand up as a church and begin to declare, to decree, to legislate, and to announce to principalities and devils that wants to rise up and see bloodshed. We can speak to them with the authority that God has given us, and we can see the thing come down. Somebody say amen. Do you realize your power? Somebody say, I have the power. When you walk into your estate, don't walk there like a chicken that has been rained on. Walk there like a lion and begin to announce and to declare, this estate is blessed. This estate is peaceful. Begin to take authority over every spirit of crime, every spirit of gangsters. Begin to scatter them. Begin to announce that as long as I'm in this estate, there shall be peace and safety and security. That is the kind of authority that you carry. If you agree with me, shout yes. And in the name of Jesus, we speak safety. We speak security over this nation in the name of Jesus. We pray for the policemen. We ask that God of heaven, you shall indeed speak to their hearts. May they get back to sanity, and may they do the job that they've been called to do. In the mighty name of Jesus, we speak peace over our nation. Somebody says shalom. Number 7 is a triple blessing. Leviticus chapter 25 verse 21. Leviticus 25, 21 is a triple blessing. The Bible says, then I will command my blessing upon you in the sixth year, and it shall bring forth fruit for 3 years. God shall speak a blessing in the sixth year, and the blessing shall go for 3 years. Now listen to me, child of God. That is what I call the triple blessing. That God will bless you, that even if you don't work this year, you shall still be able to survive this year, next year, and the year after that. Can somebody shout amen? That is the blessing of Jubilee. Now, let me close because of time. I've shown you 7 things. Did you get them? Let's go over them quickly, please. Let's go over them quickly. What is the blessing of Jubilee? Number 1. Come on, help me now. Can you speak out loudly? I can't hear you. Number 1 is liberty. Number 1, somebody say liberty. Somebody shout, I'm free. Number 2 is what? Possession. Somebody say, I possess my possession in this year of Jubilee. Come on, say it with conviction. Say, I possess my possession in this year of Jubilee. Number 3 is what? Restoration. I'm getting everything restored. Somebody say amen. Everything the caterpillar has stolen, everything the devil has taken, everything the enemy has tried to steal from me, I am announcing that in the name of Jesus, there shall be a restoration. And the Bible still says that when a thief is arrested, he's supposed to pay back 7 times. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, whatever the devil has stolen from you in this season of Jubilee, I command a 7-fold restoration. If you agree with me, say amen. Number 4 is what? Increase. Somebody say, I'm increasing. I wish you just do, I know your neighbor, don't hit your neighbor, but just do increasing. I'm increasing in the name of Jesus. I'm increasing on the left and increasing on the right. In the mighty name of Jesus, my storehouse is increasing. My bank account is increasing. My joy is increasing. My business is increasing. Whatever I try to do is increasing. I prophesy an increase in every dimension of my life. Somebody say amen. I'm increasing. My children are increasing. I have two. Next year, I'm increasing to three. Come on, somebody. Somebody say, I'm increasing. I'm increasing. I've been single. I'm about to increase and become double. Amen. Only this shall decrease, but everything else shall increase. Okay, number five is freedom from oppression. Every oppression from hell, oppression of sickness, oppression of disease, oppression of losing things, oppression of robbers, oppression of gangsters, I command it in this year of Jubilee to be broken in the name of Jesus. I release you from every oppression, oppression of sin, oppression of lack of joy, lack of sleep. You go to bed, you can't sleep. You have food and no appetite. I decree in the name of Jesus that in this year of Jubilee, you shall experience freedom in the name of Jesus. Lift up your hand and shout, I'm free. Number six is what? Safety. Somebody shout safety. Now listen to me, child of God, you shall not fall in the hands of gangsters. I pronounce you that in this year of Jubilee, you shall not fall into the hands of gangsters. I prophesy you shall not fall in the hands of gangsters. They shall see you come this way, but they shall take off before you. You shall not fall into the hands of people trying to steal your money. You shall not fall into the hands of con men. I command your money to be safe. Your investment shall be safe. Your land shall be safe. What is being stolen from other people, you shall be exempted from it in this year of Jubilee. Can somebody say amen? And as a nation, we speak safety. We pronounce security. We decree we are safe. We pray for our police force. Let them wake up in the name of Jesus. And finally, number seven is what? Triple blessing. Come on, shout it out loud. Triple blessing. You shall be blessed this year. That blessing shall go to 2014. And by 2015, what God gave in 2013 shall still be around. Can somebody say amen? Now let me tie together. Jesus comes and goes to the temple, and it finds a place where it's written in the book of Isaiah 61, where the Bible says he takes the Bible and he says, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor. And then he says, he has anointed me to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. What was Jesus saying? Jesus was saying that there's a new season that I've come to start. I have come to start a season where I, Jesus, shall become your Jubilee. So that, hear me, so that the moment you believe in me, and the moment you come to me, and the moment you accept me as your Lord and Savior, you enter into a season of perpetual Jubilee. So that, yes, there'll be seasons of experiencing and rejoicing and reflecting. But even after those seasons are over, even 20 years from now, 5 years from now, 3 years from now, you shall not have to wait until 2063 for you to enjoy the next season of Jubilee. But because Jesus has become your Lord, you have now entered into the season of Jubilee. So ladies and gentlemen, for us as Christians, Jubilee is not just a season, but Jubilee is a person. I said Jubilee is a person. His name is Jesus. His name is the Messiah. He comes and says, I have come to speak and to declare the acceptable ear of the Lord. And I want to announce something to you. When you come to Jesus, you don't just enter into a season only, but you enter into a person. When you need the triple blessing, he has the triple blessing. When you need safety, he becomes your safety. When you need liberty, he sets you free. When you need to come from oppression, he is able to set you free. Today, I have come to present Jesus to you. You may not be a Kenyan. You may have come from Zimbabwe or from South Africa or from the United States of America. And probably as I speak to you, you're wondering, this Jubilee thing has to do with the Kenyans. No, this Jubilee thing has to do everything with everyone that is in Christ Jesus. Because now in Christ Jesus, we have entered into a season of perpetual Jubilee. And I can announce to you, child of God, you don't have to wait for the next 50 years. But in 2014, you shall be in Jubilee. In 2015, you shall be in Jubilee. In 2016, you shall be in Jubilee. In 2020, you shall be in Jubilee. When you wake up in the morning, it's Jubilee. When you go to bed at night, it's Jubilee. When you're having lunch, it's Jubilee. You know why? Because Jesus has become your Jubilee. Tell people, tell them, I have a Jubilee. His name is Jesus. His name name is Jesus. And Jesus says, I have come, and this is what I've come to do. I have come to preach the good news to the poor. The good news to the poor. Touch your neighbor, talk about good news to the poor. Now, what is the good news to the poor? The good news to the poor is that you don't have to be poor anymore. That is the good news to the poor. The poor want to hear there is a way out. And I came to tell you that in this season of Jubilee, the good news to the poor is this. There is a triple blessing that is about to hit your life. When that blessing hits you, that's why you need to connect yourself with Jesus and begin to love Jesus. Because when he does it in your life, you're coming out of that chalk. You're coming out of that mess. You're coming out of that poverty. I hate poverty with everything in me. Now, I know people want me to make excuses, and they want to make me feel bad because of God blessing me. I make no excuses. I am blessed, and who can curse what God has blessed? And if you think I'm blessed, I came to announce to you the best is yet to come. And I decree, I am not blessed because I'm special. I'm not blessed because I'm a preacher. I'm not blessed because I'm married to Pastor Kathy. I am blessed because the Jubilee, whose name is Jesus Christ, he's my Lord, he's my Savior, and he's my God. And the same blessing that he's blessed me with, I came to let somebody know, you can receive it today. That blessing can get you out of sickness. It will get you out of poverty. It will get you from fighting with your husband and release you to a place of freedom. That is the will of God for you. Every chain, he says, he has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to announce that every captive, every captive is going free. I want to tell somebody that the prison you have been in, today in the name of Jesus, the 8th of December, the year of new beginnings, I prophesy you're getting out of that prison. You're getting out of that captivity. I pray for you right now. Every chain of alcoholism, every chain of drug addiction, every chain of habits that have kept you down, I announce there's captivity. Every captivity is being turned around, and Jehovah God is coming to touch you and to minister to you. Can somebody say amen? Sit down, let me talk this thing and wind it up. You see, Pastor, Brother Paul, one thing you have to understand is this, is there cannot be a national jubilee until there is an individual jubilee. There cannot be a national freedom unless you and I are free. Yeah, because Kenya is not just a land. Kenya is the people that live within the land. The land is not important than the people. We are more important than the land. So if I go free, the land has no problem. That's why I tell you, places don't make people. People make places. And if you're a grass, if you're a lizard in Kenya, you cannot be a crocodile in the UK. Are you hearing what I'm saying? If you're a lizard in Kenya, you cannot be a crocodile in America. You can only manifest who you are. That's why, ladies and gentlemen, cancel the trip. Forget the visa. Stop looking for the green card. Right here in this nation. I said, right here in this nation, you shall increase. You shall prosper. You shall be free. You shall have shalom. The blessing of God shall overtake you. Can somebody say amen? Do you realize, Mr. Morris, you're such a beautiful nation? That right now, as I'm speaking, there are nations that are under snow. When they come out to the house, they have to remove snow. From their cars, they have to move snow. But in Kenya, sunshine, 365 days in a year, the only thing we have is rain. Hey! How dare you want to leave this nation that is so blessed? God lives here. I said, God lives here. And goes once in a while to visit another nation. But this is the nation that God lives. The one that's called God's nest. It's the place where God lives, and I decree that in the name of Jesus, your eyes shall be opened and you shall see where God is taking you. The problem is not with the nation, the problem is that we are blind.
You don't see the opportunity around us. And I've always told you, the places with problems have the greatest opportunity. Amen. And the Bible actually says, may your eyes be opened. May you have a vision. May you see where God is taking you. I pray for Kenya. And I pray for Kenyans. Because Kenyans are more important than Kenya. I pray for us as Kenyans that together we shall unite. We shall hold our hands together. We shall refuse to be divided. We shall not fight one another. But as we celebrate this season of Jubilee, we shall lift up our hands together and rejoice because God gave us the best nation on the face of the earth. And from this day, we shall speak well of Kenya. We shall speak, we shall pronounce blessing and favor over Kenya. We shall not speak doom. You see, one of the things you have to realize, you have to separate the leaders from the country. When you go to the United States of America, they may not like Obama, but they love America. And they will never speak evil of America. They don't like the politicians, but they love their nation. That is the attitude we need to have. That even if you have a problem with the leaders of Kenya, don't hate the country because of the leaders. The leaders will come and go, but the country will always be here. And we will leave this country for our children and our children's children. And I pray that this nation, when Jeremy takes over in this nation, and now he's a man in church. Come on, Jeremy. Can you put the camera on Jeremy and let him, he's right here. Come on, Jeremy, stand up on your feet. Come on, son. Hey, man, when this guy takes over and the nation, and these are the guys that are in church. Amen. When he takes over, guess what? We are going to leave them a beautiful nation. We're going to leave them a beautiful country. I pray for you that is watching me by television. Jesus is our Jubilee. Jesus is the reason for the season. And if you can look up to him, it doesn't matter what you're going through today. He is able to break you from every captivity. He is able to set you free from every calamity, every situation that is surrounding you. Jesus has come and he said, I am anointed. The Spirit of God is upon me so that I can set every captivity free. Every sickness, every disease takes off at the name of Jesus. There is no chain. There is no fetter. There is no situation that Jesus cannot be able to fix. And today, all you need to do is to raise your eyes to him and ask him, Jesus, help me. And guess what? Right there, where you are, he shall come and begin to be your Lord, to break every captivity, to break every chain, to come in and take over your life. Jesus is your Jubilee. And when you have Jesus, whether it's 2013 or 2023, you shall still be enjoying the season of Jubilee because Jesus unleashes us and releases us to a perpetual Jubilee that is everlasting. And therefore today, in the name of Jesus, wherever you are, if you're not born again, Jesus is right there asking you, open your heart. Let me come in and be your Lord and Savior. Let me be your God. And once you open your heart, he comes in and gives you a new beginning. You don't have to feel sorry for yourself. You don't have to feel abandoned and forsaken. He says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. He says, I am a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. He is right where you are. And today, in this sea of Jubilee, I want to pray for you to give your life to Jesus. The numbers on the screens are numbers that you can call right now, and somebody's waiting to pray with you and to talk to you. But if you'd like to give your life to Jesus right now, let's bow our heads and pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for those who are watching me by TV, speak to their hearts and let them come to you. Now, if you're watching me by TV, please, and you want to ask Jesus to come into your heart, kindly just say this prayer with me. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I come to you. I am a sinner needing forgiveness. You are my Jubilee, Jesus. Please come into my life. Come, take over. Be my Lord. Be my God. Oh, Jesus, I surrender everything to you. I give my family, my children, my marriage, my business. I give them over to you, Jesus. Be Lord in my life. I've opened my heart to you. Come in, Jesus. Save me. Save me. Be my God. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you pray that prayer, call the number on the screen right now. There's somebody waiting to pray for you. Once again, thank you so much, KTN, for allowing us to minister the word of God. We are handing you over to Tukuza. Thank you also for allowing me to go a little bit over time. We love you guys and thank you so much. Please don't touch that dial. Jesus is the reason of Jubilee. God bless you so much and have yourself a wonderful, wonderful week. Come on, appreciate the Lord. And remember also, on Wednesday, we shall be at Uhuru Park. And then, of course, on 12th, the president will be leading the whole nation in enjoying the season of Jubilee. And then on 13th is a public holiday where you can call in your family and just go ahead and talk about the blessing of Jubilee. But let me say this again. I appreciate you deeply.
for a time of passionate praise and worship. Anointed presentations. And a time of life-changing teaching, training, and equipping ministry.
Greatness is not the accumulation of money or toys or accolades, but it is the fulfilling of your God-given assignment in life, while at the same time impacting and changing people's lives through service.
Jubilee Christian Church, teaching, training, and equipping.